Once you do that, now we need to create a table maintenance generator. We do that by selecting utilities and selecting table maintenance generator. We need to select an authorization group. So for this case, we are not going to work with authorization groups. So we select without authorization group. We need to specify a function group for this table. This is going to be the name of the function group created for this table. So let's use the same name as the table for the function group. This is a really good way to remember the function group that is associated with each table. The maintenance type of the screens, let's select one step. Let's type a number for our first screen. Later on, I'm gonna explain what are screens and why they have numbers, but for now, let's just type 100 for our first screen. And let's click on create our table maintenance generator. The system asks for a package. Yes, we select the same package. It asks for a change request. We select the same one. And now the system is creating a table maintenance generator that we can use to input values for our table. So after the generation is complete, we can navigate to transaction SM30 to call the view maintenance that we just generated. Remember, this function group that we use is the one that we're going to remember to use in the SM30 transaction. So I'm gonna copy it for now to the clipboard. Now we go back to the SAP Easy Access menu and we navigate to the SM30 transaction. This is the transaction to maintain our tables. That means to maintain the data stored in our tables. Not all tables have the table maintenance generator. So we type in our table, our view, and then we click on maintain to enter some data. The subsystem is compiling our created table maintenance generator. This only happens the first time you run the table maintenance generator. The second time, the third time, and so on, the generator starts automatically. So now we can add new entries for our table passengers. So let's add some entries. The ID, this is taken from the data element we used. Remember, we type ID for a short description. It's going to be ID1. Then this is the name of our passenger. Since we used remember, we use a car50 data element type. That is a generic type that doesn't have a text for a description. So that's why the system displays a plus sign. Let's correct that by creating data element types real quick. First, so let's go back. Let's go back. No, I don't want to say for now. I need to go back to the ABAP dictionary, to the database table, change, and I need to create data elements for this. So I'm gonna do this real quick. Name ZDE last name. Double click. Yes, created. This is the name. I'm going to use a predefined type this time. That is a car of 50. The field 10, 20, 30 and 40. And this is the name. Oops, sorry. I activate it. Yes, I select my object. I go back. Now I want to create the other data element for the last name. So last name, also a predefined type that is car of 50 positions. The field is 10, 20, 30 and 40. This is last name. Last name. I activate. And now I can use my data element in my table. So I go back. And now, oh, see, I have a mistake here, so I go back again. Let's see where our problem is. Oh, here it is. Last name. Go back. Now it's okay. Now I activate also my table. The table had changes. That's why I have to activate it again. I change the data element. So I need to activate one more time my table. Now that it's active, I need to generate again my table maintenance generator. So I go to table maintenance and I click on edit this time. Change. The type was changed. Remember the data element was. So I need to tell it to create the maintenance screen again. So it's gonna create again that table, but with the correct titles now. The create the models. New field. No, I didn't create a new field. And another text. No, that's okay. I click OK. Okay, overview screen. Okay, it's gonna delete and recreate. Yes, I want that because I want the text to be generated. Okay, now it was complete. I save, I go back. I check that it is active. Yes, it is. So I go back. And I go back to the SM30 transaction, the view maintenance call. Click enter. Now I click on maintain. And now, as you can see, now it was changed. Now I can see the ID, the name, and the last name. So I click on new entries, and I start adding new entries. So my ID 1, this is going to be called John Cash. And its date of birth, because it is type data, that's the standard data element comes with a predefined a calendar, so you can choose the date. This was born, let's say, was born today. Let's add another person, Harry. Whooper. And the date. Let's be more realistic this time. He was born on 19. '80. Oh well. We can change it here also. Let's change the other one so it could be a more realistic example. 1982. And now we save. and now two entries were added to our table. So now our passengers table has two passengers in it, John and Harry.